For this video, we're going to review the shortcut to determine your equilibrium equation, the equation that uses our x values from our ice tables. Going to work through two examples and then show the results of some more examples on the next slide. For our example of silver bromide that we just worked through on the last screen, that salt dissociates in a 1-to-1 ratio. And as we saw in our ice table, because each of our ions solves down to a value of x, our Ksp equation comes out to be x squared. If I was working with an example like lead-2-chloride, if I were to set up an ice table at equilibrium, I wouldn't have any lead-2-chloride. I would just have a value of x for the lead ion and a value of 2x for chloride. Realize that in all of our examples we're going to work, the initials will always be zero, and so at equilibrium, we will just have the amount of change. And so the shortcut version would be if you wanted to just set up the equilibrium row from our ice table, and then to set up our Ksp expression. This step is always required in your work, so you would be doing this anyway. But realize that if I set up my equilibrium expression, then I plug in each equilibrium value. So the lead ion is just a value of x. My chloride ion is a value of 2x, and that is quantity squared, squared because of the 2 from my equilibrium expression. When I solve this out, I get an equation of 4x cubed. So any salt that dissociates in a 1-to-2 ratio, like we have here in lead-2-chloride, or 2-to-1, the order doesn't matter of those, any salt that dissociates in that ratio solves out to be 4x cubed. Let's try a little bit more complicated one with calcium phosphate here. So same idea, if I just write my equilibrium row for my ice table, calcium phosphate's not included. The calcium ion would be a 3x, the phosphate would be a 2x. Setting up my equilibrium expression for this salt, I have the calcium ion cubed, the phosphate ion squared. Plugging in my equilibrium values, I have 3x quantity cubed for calcium. I have 2x quantity squared for phosphate. So the key thing to recognize here in being able to write the shortcut is notice that my coefficient for each ion gets used twice. It's both a coefficient for x and the exponent in my equation. The coefficient of 2 for phosphate is both the coefficient of x and the exponent. When you solve all of this out, you come out with a value of 108x to the fifth. And so the summary slide that I have here next summarizes all of this. So again, any salt in a 1-to-1 ratio would be x squared. Any salt in a 1-to-2 or 2-to-1 ratio would be 4x cubed. We just solved for calcium phosphate as 108x to the fifth. I will encourage you to work through an example, something like iron 3 hydroxide. You should realize that it solves out to be 27x to the fourth. And then I have a 1-to-4 or 4-to-1 ratio here. These are rare. In fact, so rare I couldn't think of an example for this slide. But if you were to solve it out, you would see that it comes out to be 256x to the fifth. So for purposes of showing work, you do not need to set up an ice table. If you want to, you can set up just the equilibrium row to make sure you're plugging in the right quantities. For our next video, we're going to work through two examples, working salts that aren't a 1-to-1, so you can see how this would apply. And I will see you in just a few minutes.